People say practice makes perfect. Well, that's not true for everything. For example, there are certain things that the body just can't do, or at least your genes can't. Hello everyone, this is One Away. In this video, we're going to learn about the 12 things humans can't do, or well, most of us can't. So, are you a real-life superhuman? Or just an average one? Let's find out. Number 12. Raising one eyebrow. Raising your eyebrow has been a common facial expression for surprise or disapproval. But did you know that it is actually humanly impossible to raise one? Go ahead, we'll give you 5 seconds to try it for yourself. You might say, well, I'm raising one eyebrow now. But the thing is, you're actually not. Instead, you keep one eyebrow down and raise both at the same time, thus giving the impression of only raising one. So, if one person is not able to raise one eyebrow, it actually means that they are not able to keep the other side down. This is because our eyebrows sit on one and the same muscle, the occipital frontalis. It is possible that one side is not connected or less connected, which is why a person can raise only one of his eyebrows, but not both. So, can you raise both of your eyebrows independently from the other? Wait to be blown away by our number one. 11. Lick your elbow. Here's a tough one. Try licking your elbow. You can't, can you? This is because licking your elbow needs a combination of short arms, flexible shoulders, and a long tongue. If you have all three, then congratulations, you have a unique yet senseless skill. But if you're just like most of us who can't, you can try and try until you succeed. Just make sure there's no one looking around. Number 10. Nose twitching. You might have seen a cat or a bunny twitch their nose, or even watched Samantha Stephens of Bewitched do. But did you know that nose twitching is not so common for humans? This is because nose twitching is often caused by involuntary movement or spasm. In fact, nose twitching may be caused by muscle cramps, dehydration or stress, or more serious causes like vitamin and mineral deficiency, nerve damage, or Tourette's syndrome. So, you might not want your nose to twitch. Number 9. Ear wiggling. Ear movement is pretty common for mammals, but humans find it difficult. It takes 3 muscles to wiggle your ears. The auricularis anterior for up and forward movement, the auricularis superior, which raises it, and the auricularis posterior, which pulls it backwards. Another factor for ear wiggling is found in your genes. It is observed that people who can wiggle their ears have one or both of their parents who also can. But some argue that evolution is to blame. Ear wiggling is an important feature to hunt and survive. But as humans evolved, it seems that ear wiggling is no longer needed. And so, evolution is doing its part to get it out of the picture. What do you think? Number 8. Putting your fist in your mouth. The answer is simple. The average adult hands are between 6 inches and 11 inches, and a regular mouth is 2.75 inches. So, to put your fist in your mouth means you either have very small hands, or a huge mouth, or both. 7. Tongue tricks. Try touching your nose with your tongue. How about touching your chin? Now try rolling, folding, or even rotating your tongue. Tongue rolling is a dominant trait of your gene. This means if your parents both have this gene, you can do so. But environment and anatomy also play a big factor whether you can roll your tongue or not. For example, to touch your nose or chin with your tongue, you need to have a long tongue and/or a dislocated jaw to do so. Number 6. Bodily multitasking. Try moving your foot clockwise, then the same side hand counterclockwise. Did you do it? It is proven that no one can do the number 6 in our list on their first try. And the answer is simply how our brain does stuff. There is only one set of nerve cells that facilitate each side of the body. So when you do two opposite actions on the same side, your brain simply gets confused. Number 5. Talking while inhaling. Remember that time when you were running out of breath and you try to talk? You can't do it simultaneously, can you? This is because when we speak, air comes out of the larynx to vibrate the vocal cords and make sounds and create speech, while inhaling means breathing in air. Also, the air pressure in speaking is really different from the one when we inspire. Number 4. Tickle yourself. This has something to do on why we feel ticklish in the first place. It is actually a defense response because our brain thinks we're in danger and sends us in a state of panic. But when we tickle ourselves, our brain is actually aware of the sensation. After all, it's the same brain that causes the movement. So, the lesson here is that you can trick yourself. Number 3. Gleeking. Gleeking is when saliva shoots out from under the tongue. It's like spitting with extra steps. It actually happens randomly and involuntarily, and often when we yawn. It happens when the muscles in the floor of our mouth are compressed when our tongue moves upwards. And when there's just so much saliva, you just have to spit it out, or in this case, gleek. Number 2. Chug it all. You have to admit, drinking 8 glasses of water a day is pretty difficult. What more is chugging a glass in 1 second? The key is to open up your throat. Instead of chugging it over and over, your throat becomes like a pool slide from your mouth to your stomach. Just a heads up, if you're going to do speed drinking, do it with caution. Some have attempted to try it but ended up choking and somehow drowning. If you think that's already impossible, wait till you see our top one. Number 1. Endless run. Running 5 kilometers is already exhausting for most of us, unless you're a marathoner. But you'll have to cramp and stop at some point, right? Well, meet Dion Karnazes, the man who can run forever. And by forever, we mean he never gets tired. One time, he ran for 3 days and 3 nights non-stop. This is because of a rare genetic condition that causes his body to flash away lactic acid. Lactic acid is the product when our body uses energy, which signals fatigue and causes cramps. Since Karnazes doesn't have any, he practically never feels exhaustion. That's a real-life superhuman. Well, there you have it, folks. Our top 12 things humans can't do. How many did you try? Are you a 1 in a million or just an average human being? Let us know in the comments section below. Until next time, this is 108.